So we're continuing on our series of wiring diagrams, and this time we're back in with a two-plate method, but now it's two-plate method, two-way and intermediate. So we've got two two-way switches and an intermediate one. Previous video, we did the two-way on two-plate method. Remember, the two-plate method is where we take the feed directly to the switch. There are plenty of videos on the channel using the three-plate method, but it's common now in industry, especially where the lighting points, I've only shown one here, are lots of LED downlights. So where we've got a lot of LED downlights, general wiring system now in new domestic dwellings is to take the feed from, in this case, the consumer unit directly to the switch. The feed could come from another room, which is also either doing the two-plate or three-plate method. Generally, you keep it to the same method throughout the installation, and I've done a video where I'm in someone's house looking at the two-plate method as well. So, two-way and intermediate. So we've got one gang, one switch on the front, two-way switch with a common and two other terminals. They're called L1 and L2 on this one, but they can be called something slightly different. So that's our two-way switch. We've got our intermediate switch in the middle. Just be careful on the wiring diagram that this here is the top and this is the bottom. Sometimes people can do a wiring diagram the other way around. We haven't here, but that's still the top and those are the bottom. Okay, it doesn't matter which way around we go with our cables, but we've got to make sure we get a pair in the top and a pair in the bottom and not across the side. And that's often a mistake my learners make in the workshop when wiring these up. So that is in the correct rotation for a one gang intermediate switch, and again on the end we've got a one gang two-way switch. And I've said before, you can have as many intermediate switches as you like as long as at each end you have two-way switches. And I've done a video where I've extended a two-way circuit to add another intermediate switch, so if you want to see how to do that, again check out that video. So two-plate method, taking the feed into the first switch. So let's start off by bringing in our CPC. I'm going to do this upside down, so just be careful and remember, I'll expect you to use a rule. All of these drawings are downloadable with a link in the description, so if you want to make your own drawings up for college, you can. Or if you're doing some distance learning, that's another good way of doing it, so you can download the drawing. So take the CPC, this is the earth terminal, this is the neutral, and this is where the fuse would be connected. Pretty much this is the only section of the drawing that isn't identical to how you would wire it up in the real world. This is just representing the top of the circuit breaker, the neutral bar and the earth bar in the consumer unit, but the connections within all the switches will be identical for a wiring diagram. So let's bring our CPC in. So I'm just going to bring it up as if it's gone around the fabric of the building, up a wall, etc., and it's made its way to the actual switch itself. And I'm going to bring it round like so, so it's there into the earth terminal. Now it could be that you've got a metal box and the earth terminal is in the back of it. In college we're using boxes that are plastic. Again, they do have an earth terminal in the back. So that cable's brought in, and it's being brought in on this one here, which is our feed in, which is our permanent line, CPC and our neutral. And at college we use 1mm² twin and CPC, often called on-site twin and earth cable. So that's what I'm simulating here, the feed coming in. And remember, we would over-sleeve the CPC with green and yellow sleeving. I've represented it currently with a green cable, but I'm going to make it green and yellow by just taking a yellow strike down it and bring that round. Like so. So that's our CPC within our first cable. So that's taking the feed from, in this case, the consumer unit into the actual switch itself. Let's bring the neutral in. So it's in the same cable, got a blue neutral. And in this style of switch that we've got here, there are no facilities for a neutral connection. I know some manufacturers do give you a terminal that you can actually connect your neutral into. These don't, which is fine. So we're gonna make our own connection in there. I'll show that connection in the form of a little rectangle. So that's, in other words, a connector. Now that can look like the following. It could be something like that, which is from Ideal Industries, a levered connector from Wago. It could be a screwed connector, old-fashioned screwed-in 5-amp connector, or a through butt or splice crimp, depending on what you want to call it. Generally at college, we've been using the levered variety of Wago connectors in order to make our connection, but any of those would be acceptable to make a connection in the back of the box for the neutral. Okay, so that's it. So we've now got to bring our permanent line in. So that's coming out the top of our 6-amp breaker for us. And we've got to make a decision where that's going to go within our switch. So that's bringing our permanent line connection in. It wouldn't matter where we go out of these two terminals here. which are L1 and L2. Okay, it wouldn't matter which one they go in, but I don't put it into common because I always use black as common, a discussion we've had on Instagram with my Instagram followers. Remember, you can check out GSA Electrical on Instagram as well. Asking people what color they used in common. I always use black. Other people use different colors, so my drawing will have black as common. So I'm gonna bring in my feed and I'm gonna bring it into here. Doesn't matter whether it's L1 or L2, it's the nearest point for me in my switch for order the connections. It keeps it less messy. So let's bring that one into there. So what I've done, I've brought in from either, in this case, the consumer unit or another room, the permanent line, neutral and CPC directly into my switch. And this is the two plate method. I'm now gonna have to introduce cables that come through here in order to have the switching system correct. So the next cable we're gonna need to introduce could be the one up to the actual light or the one between here and here. I'm gonna stick with this one. So I'm now gonna bring a cable from here, from the switch up to my lighting point itself. Again, this is going to be a 1mm² twin and CPC or twin and earth cable. So I'm gonna bring up to the lighting point, let's move this out of the way, up to the lighting point here. It will need a neutral, which is gonna come from this connector block here. It will need a protective conductor, a CPC from here, and it will need a switching line conductor. So this one coming out of this switch up to the lighting point doesn't wanna be connected here, because that's permanent line. It needs to come out of a different part. It's gonna come out of here as my switching line conductor. So let's bring those out. So we bring out, what should we start with? Let's start with the CPC. So let's bring out a CPC and I'm gonna connect it into here. Remember, I expect you to use a rule. So that's coming from the switch up to our lighting point, which is possibly some LED spots, things like that. So that's in. We can do next, we've got a choice. So I'm gonna bring out either my neutral or my switching line. So let's bring out my switching line next. My switching line conductor comes up, again, comes into my joint. Doesn't matter where I connect it inside this joint here. So it could be that I'm connecting it onto the appropriate terminals of the back of an LED light. It could be that I've got an LED light fitting that has a flex with it and therefore will require a joint on it. And that joint could be made in a Wago box. It could be made in a purpose-built connector. So in here, there's a set of connectors. Could be in this style of box here or this style of box here. So we're just representing the fact that we've got a form of connection here before our light, and this is meant to be for us an LED spot. So that's brought out our switching line connection, our CPC. Now we've got to get a neutral. So I'm going to try and make this as clear as I can without obviously clashing with some cables. So I'm going to have to come out of here and I'm going to have to bring a neutral out. So let's bring, how can we make that look as neat as possible? Let's just bring it up here like so, and then across to make our neutral connection. So what we've got there is, from the switch, we've come out of the other one out of L1 and L2, it doesn't matter which one I chose. That will be our switching line, our CPC, and our neutral connection that come up to here. At the minute it wouldn't work, obviously, because we've not completed the cable-in system that goes between our intermediate switch and our other two-way switch. That's the start of our wiring diagram. So this cable here is a 1mm² PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable, often called twin and earth. This one here is also a PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable, twin and earth, and they're 1mm² for us. Feed in, switching line, neutral and CPC out. Now we're going to introduce a cable between our two-way switches. It's always the same, whether it be the two-plate or three-plate method. Remember, this is the two-plate method. I'm going to introduce a three-core. So we've got brown, black, grey, and quite a tarnished circuit protective conductor there, which again will need to be oversleeved at connection, so the drawing always shows that as green and yellow. So from this switch, we're going to introduce this three-core and CPC or three-core and earth cable. Again, it's 1mm². Now it's gonna take a journey, isn't it, from this switch, maybe up a wall or down a wall, through floors possibly, or through ceilings in order to get from this point to this point. However, it's the connections we're looking at that are important, not necessarily the route the cable takes. So I'm just gonna come sideways with this one. It would obviously take the journey through the fabric of building accordingly. So I said to you that my black is going to be the one that I'm going to link from my common. Well, there is no common connection. An intermediate switch. You've just got two terminals and two terminals, sometimes labeled L1, L2, L1, L2, can be L1, 2, 3, and 4, but it's top and bottom. So the three core cable that comes from this switch to here either goes in the top two connections or it goes in the bottom two. It doesn't matter which, but what it doesn't do is go across the sides. So as I'm bringing my cables through, I don't want them to come into this side and then a cable from here going out. It's got to go in the top two or the bottom two, but it doesn't matter. So it's either these two or these two. However, there is no facility in here for my connection for my common because I've drawn in there that connector. So I'm going to bring my black from this common into my connector, and then I'm going to work out my other two cables from here across to here in my three core. So I'm going to take my black first. My black conductor comes out of my common. So we can either go down and along, and I'm going to bring it into there. So that's my black connection. And again, we know it's a switching line connection. So at each end, I need to identify it with brown sleeving. So I need to oversleeve my brown conductor to identify it as a switching line connection. So that's in a joint. Remember what we said, it could be any of the following styles of connection in order to make it in here. And I've shown a traditional connector block, but it's more likely to be something like that. So that's the first one. So that's the black one done. Okay, we know the CPC. If we want to do that next, get rid of it. We're just going to bring our CPC across. So our CPC and our three core cable would come across like so, and again just strike it with a little bit of yellow in order that we can see that CPC. So that's got rid of the black and the CPC, it just leaves me two cables left. So we've got the brown and the gray. So for me now, I know this one here comes through and is my permanent line, and this one here is my switching line. So I like to make the brown of the three core come in here and the gray in here. It could be the other way around, doesn't matter, but it makes logical sense to leave the one that's permanently connected to the line to be the brown in the three core. So that's why I don't use brown as common, which some people do. So that one would be permanent line. So let's bring that through. So my three core, I'm going to bring up my brown through here, and I've got to make a choice. So if I'm going to bring that one, I'm probably going to put it over. What did I do last time? Just confirm I did it last time. I brought it into the first one. So I'll bring it in like so. So that's my brown through. Okay, and then I've got my gray. So I take my gray out of the L1 or L2, it doesn't matter which. And I'll bring that along and kick it into there like so. So let's go. So what have we got? We've got the black from here, the three core cable comes into a connector, and we identify it with brown and sleeving. We've got the brown out of the one with the permanent line, L1 or L2, it doesn't matter, and it comes across into the top of our intermediate switch or the bottom. It doesn't matter which, it could have come in either way round, but obviously for the drawing's sake, it's gone in the top for ease. And then we've got our gray conductor out of L1 or L2 of our switch. So L1 or L2, it doesn't matter which, as long as you're keeping it correct as we come through to here. And again, we've got to identify that gray conductor as a switching line connection with brown sleeve in both ends. So well, let's have a quick look at what's happened there. We're taking the feed into our switch. We've made the appropriate connections. We've taken a cable out to our light switch, and we've come out of here, our neutral block and our CPC in order to bring our switching line connection up. We've introduced a three core cable from our two way switch to our intermediate. We've deposited the black connection into a connector or some sort of lever connector in there, so not connected within the switch itself. And we've put the other two conductors either in the top two or the bottom two of the switch, and we've brought those through. All we need to do now is introduce another three core across to our next switch. So we use the three core again. So it would be nice and simple now. We've got to take out a black to come to our common, so we can come out the bottom again if we want to and come round for our common, or we could come out the top and round, whichever we fancy. It's only a wiring diagram, remember. So if I bring out a connection out of here, like so, I bring my black through to my common of my final two-way switch for this one. Let's identify both ends with brown sleeving. That's my first three core introduced. Again, it's going to take a route through the fabric of the building required. That's got rid of the black. CPC is going to link the two together. Nice and simple to get rid of those. So we get rid of our CPCs. Like that. And now we've just got to bring our three core into our L1 and L2. And it doesn't matter. Again, we could have brown here and gray there coming across to here. It doesn't have to match here either. It's just that we have a brown or a gray coming out over to here and here. There is no requirement for them to match, and there's no requirement for them to match here. However, logically, we always like to, don't we? We like to have the grey opposite the grey, the brown opposite the brown. But let's go with that. So let's bring out our brown. So we're going to bring that out and round. And let's connect it into here, like so. And then we'll bring out our grey. I'm going to bring that round and we're going to connect it like so. Remembering we've got to identify, again, with brown sleeving, both ends of our grey. Like so. So that's made our connections. So I've introduced a three-core between here and here, and a three-core between here and here. And this is our wiring diagram for our two-way and intermediate when we've got the two-plate method in play. So two-plate method means the feed goes to the switch. And then we make our connections appropriately in here. Permanent line here, neutral in a connector, CPC. We introduced a switching line, a neutral and a CPC that comes out to our light fitting. And then we introduced a three core between our switches. I've also done a video where I've explained these connections on a board. So I've actually physically made all of these connections. And these two videos would work hand in hand together. So this wiring diagram starts the process of understanding the connections. Then the video will help you make those connections. But it's only over time of doing this in industry that you'll get comfortable with taking the feed to the switch. Okay, so that's the wiring diagram for the two-plate method for two-way and intermediate. I was asked before about how to add another switch in, and I've done that in another video. How could I make this, say, for instance, have another switch that way? Okay, so what you end up doing is taking this one off and moving it to the next position and put another intermediate switch here, make the connections accordingly, which would put the black into a connector. You keep these two, one side of the intermediate switch, you'd introduce a three-core going that way. But there is a video on how to add more intermediate switches, whether it be two-plate or three-plate, the same process to the actual switching system that we've got here. So hopefully this completes the current part of the series on two-plate. So we did the one-way, the two-way, and the intermediate switching of a lighting circuit when you take the feed to the switch, often called the two-plate method. So as always, I hope this video has been some help.